Hello guys, welcome to SoapUI web service testing tutorial. In this tutorial, we are going to understand about the XPath assertion in SoapUI. So in the last tutorial, we have seen that some of the basic assertions that you can use. And now let's dig into the advanced assertions. And the first assertion that we'll be looking at is the XPath assertion. Now to do the XPath assertion, it's pretty similar, so you have to open the request. So this is the multiply request that I have opened. Let me close that. Yep, so here I'm in the test suite and I have opened the test step multiply. Now we have added, these are the basic assertions that we added. To add an XPath assertion, it's same, you just click on the plus sign and go to property content. In the property content, you'll find XPath match. Highlight that and click on add. And just say XPath. I mean, you can provide any unique name that you want. So for example, I want to verify the multiply result. I'll say multiply result and click OK. Now here you have the XPath assertion window where you need to provide the namespace, you need to declare the namespace and provide the XPath in order to verify the content of the XPath. Okay, so the first step that you do is to declare the namespace. You see that button here, click on that and it will get all the namespaces that are available in the XPath in that particular response. Okay, now below that you have to provide the actual path. So XPath is nothing but the location of the node where you will find that particular value in the response. All right, now how you can traverse to that particular location. So if you click on the response here, let me change that, let me close this first, change it to response because we are going to verify response, and then again open the XPath assertion and click on add or cancel that. I'll open this same one. Okay, now declare again. Now here how you can reach this multiply result node in the XPath. So you have to basically verify which, under which namespace or which namespace this node belongs to. So you can see httptempuri.org is the namespace below which this particular node is. Okay, so what you can say is you can just say forward slash and then you can provide ns1 namespace and then colon and multiply result. Okay, so just type in multiply result and that will give you that particular node. Okay, so basically this is the address of this particular node. Or if you don't want to provide a specific node, you can also provide the wild card here, because sometimes if it is not able to identify with the specific node or namespace, you just provide the wild card and will look for this particular node in all the response and it will give the result. Now what is the expected result you are trying to verify? We are trying to verify 100, that value 100 is present in this particular node. Okay, and save it. Now you can see that multiply result has returned the value, or it is valid. If I change it to 1000, it should fail. Now you can see that it failed because the actual value at this particular node is 100, but we are expecting 1000, and that's why it has failed. So that is how you do the XPath assertion and you write the XPath. And writing the XPath or traversing the XPath is pretty simple. You just have to follow the actual parent node and the child node and traverse to that particular node and then provide the value in the expected result. We'll take some other service as well, which has bit, you know, like a bit lengthy XPath to write, and then we'll explain how you can write more XPath assertion in future tutorial. Now the next thing that you can verify with the XPath assertion is, we'll just save this one and add another assertion. So we'll say property content and XPath match. So we have verified the actual value in the content. Now, if, for example, we just want to verify that particular node is present or not, XPath node is present or not, then we'll say, I'll rename it XPath node. And here, declare the namespaces again. Now, just provide the XPath. Okay, so what we are trying to verify here, say for example, we want to verify that particular node is present in this response. What we'll do is we'll just provide the name of that particular node. So for example, we are looking for the multiply result node, whether this node is present or not. Then we'll say wildcard and then multiply result. Okay, and this will basically return what value, or this particular node will return the value. Now, if you want to verify the node, you just say call the method exists and this particular node. Okay, and here in the expected result, what you say is true. Okay, so if this particular node exists, then it will return true. Okay. So XPath node, you can see here that it has returned false. It is present, and that's why it passed. If I change it to false, it should fail, right? So if you open this or highlight on this line here, so XPath comparison failed for path declare namespace this, because the node that we have specified in here is actually present, but we are expecting it to be not present there. Okay, so that's how you verify a particular node in the XPath. Okay, now that's the second very important aspect of XPath verification. So first is the verification of the actual value that is present in the particular XPath location. Second is to verify the node, whether that particular XPath node is present or not. And third very important stuff is to verify the actual response or the whole response that we are looking for. So for example, in this multiply response, we are looking this whole response and this particular structure that we are looking for, or we can even consider from here, say for example, we are looking for soap body and this particular structure in the response. So if there is any new node that appears in the response, then that particular test case will fail. Let me correct this one to true and then add another assertion for the property content and XPath verification, and then just try to verify XPath response structure. That's what we are trying to verify. Now, in this response structure that we're trying to verify, just we'll declare the namespaces same way, and then provide the path for which you want to verify. So provide the path of the node under which you want to verify the structure. So for example, I'm going to verify all the nodes below the soap body, or the structure below soap body. What I'll do is I'll just say /, star, and then colon, and then body. Okay, once you do that, click on select from current, and it will get all the XML response from below that particular tag. Okay, so multiply response, multiply result, multiply response, close, and then body close. So this will give you the whole structure. Now go through this structure and verify that this is the actual structure that you are looking for, or as a schema validation, this is what you are looking for. And if it is not that you want to select from the current and you want to write the actual expected result, as per the response structure. You can also write it here and verify that the values or the actual structure that you're looking for is present here. Now, most of the time, if you're just verifying the structure, this value might change, right? So what you can do is you can just provide the wild character here, star, and check this box, allow wild characters, and click on save. Now, if you see this assertion, it will always, when you run this request, let me run it again, it will verify that particular structure. Okay, now if I change it to anything else here, that assertion will fail because the actual response didn't contain this particular tag there. So to conclude, in this tutorial, we have learned very important XPath assertion. So first assertion that we have learned is to verify the actual value in the XPath node. So for example, you have a particular node and you want to verify the value in that particular node. So that we have verified using the node XPath. So you can traverse to that particular node and verify that the expected result contains that particular value. The second very important thing we have covered is the presence of the actual node, whether that node actually exists in the XPath or in the response XML or not. So for example, whether this multiply result node itself exists or not, that we have verified, and you have to provide the Boolean value of true or false in the expected result if you're verifying a particular node in the XML. And then the third one is the structure or the response XML structure that we have verified, and you could verify it any level that you want, either the SOAP body level or the response level that you can provide and write. And then the other important thing is you have to we have learned to allow the wildcard, so that in case the values in the nodes of the response XML change, then these assertions don't fail at all. So these are the three important XPath assertions that we have learned in the advanced assertion. In future tutorials, we will dig deeper into some more assertions in SoapUI. Hope you liked the video. Thank you very much for watching.